The internet is full of bro science, fake knowledge, half information or propaganda. Your quest of reliable, authentic health information ends here. So subscribe this channel and hit the bell icon and you never have to go anywhere else ever again.
Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome back. Today we are going to talk about various Ayurvedic and natural herbal ingredients. Though some of the things are present in your household, kitchen, and some which you can get from medical stores, which can be used for your blood pressure problem. Yes, blood pressure problem is the number one killer, silent killer, which is causing the heart problems over a period of years, and stress is a big reason why it is happening. And in such a lifestyle, 21st century, everybody is stressed. So you need to know all these basics here. So let's start. First ingredient is none other than onion. Yes, onion is an antibacterial agent and it lowers your blood pressure, and also it has a healing property. So it actually contains some flavonoids, which is called quercetin, and that can help lower your blood pressure and control hypertension a little bit, obviously, right? And so it should be a part of your diet. It has also seen in researchers to be positively effective in heart patients, and also in blocked arteries also it is positive a little bit. So this is one ingredient. Second one is garlic. Garlic is known to be helpful in heart patients in lowering cholesterol and elevating blood pressure, really relieving blood pressure. Garlic has been there right from so many years. So you can actually take a garlic clove in the morning, or you can use it in cooking, right? It's very useful. Obviously, you know that. Third thing is amla. Amla is basically Indian gooseberry. It is very rich in vitamin C. Vitamin C is useful in absorption of various ingredients. It is useful for your skin, for your immune system, right? It lowers your blood pressure as well. And it can be a part of your daily diet, can be taken empty stomach or with food. It's very good, right, for your heart as well. So amla is also very good. Green tea. Green tea has been an antioxidant, and you have to be cautious with green tea. If you take it in a mild to moderate amount, it can release your stress and reduce your blood pressure, but in a high amount it can increase your stress and make you insomniac. It will cause high blood pressure in that case. So green tea has to be used cautiously. Then there is lemon. Obviously lemon also has vitamin C, and lemon with vitamin C has the property of lowering blood pressure. All the benefits of vitamin C are there. So lemon should be a part of your diet on a daily basis whenever you have it, right? And then there is watermelon. Watermelon is very good fruit, and it has a lot of citrulline. We have made a different video on citrulline. We have a video on green tea as well, and vitamin C for that matter. Make sure to watch all those videos. And what citrulline does, citrulline goes inside and it converts into arginine. It increases the diameter of your blood vessels and reduces your blood pressure. So citrulline is very good. So watermelon should be taken whenever there is season, obviously in the summers. So watermelon is very good antioxidant as well. Obviously all the fruits have some or the other antioxidant properties. It all are good for cardiovascular diseases or any other disease for that matter. So then next is honey. Honey is it's a very widely used herbal remedy. It soothes your throat. It has antioxidant, antibacterial properties. It also has been seen to reduce your stress as well as relieve your blood pressure a little bit. All these ingredients have little effects, which combined together will give you the necessary benefit. But individually, they don't actually treat blood pressure by themselves. Remember that. Then regular consumption of all these things can help you, along with the most important ingredient is green leafy vegetables. Green vegetables and fruits. You have to take a lot of green vegetables and fruits in your diet regularly. That's basically the DASH diet, which we've already talked about in a different video. Make sure to watch that video along with reducing your salt intake. If you reduce your salt intake, take a lot of fruits, papaya, watermelon, grapes, etc., etc. They are healthy for you, healthy for your heart and your blood pressure. Carrot, spinach, having a lot of salad is a very, very important for yourself, right? In addition, for all these things, you have to make sure to be a little bit of active in your life. Now let's talk about these are all the ingredients which are present in your household, right, which you regularly take. Now let's talk about some herbs, some Ayurvedic natural herbs like Sarpagandha. Indian snake root, right? That's a plant, right? Its roots are used to make medicines, and it has been used in Ayurveda for so many years, and it is used for mainly two things, right? For the heart, blood pressure, and mental illnesses, right? And it is used because it has some chemicals which are similar to a prescription drug, allopathic drug called reserpine, and reserpine has been used in mild to moderate blood pressure, in brain problems like schizophrenia and problems of poor circulation. So it has that thing. So it reduces your heart rate, your blood pressure, and it can have a side effect of drowsiness, right? Make sure to be aware of that. Then second herb is a plant which is basically called Punarnava, also called, it's a difficult names, right? Borhavia diffusa is a plant, flowering plant. It also has a few retinoids which are used in various medical purposes. It are basically quinolone alkaloids which are there in this kind of a plant. It has shown some properties including anti-estrogen, anti-cancer, immunomodulating property, as well as anti-amoebic properties, and it can be used as anti-inflammatory and expectorant also. Alright, so tribulus. Then there is tribulus. Tribulus is a plant that produces fruits which having spines. Tribulus is also called as gokshura, and it has been rumored for so many years to be increasing your testosterone level, but make sure it does not actually increase. It has been proven in so many studies it does not increase testosterone, but yes, tribulus does increase your libido, and it is used in various other disease, sexual disease, pain, eczema, enlarged prostate, infertility. But then the actual thing, how it works by increasing certain hormone levels, but not testosterone, right? So tribulus is there. It does have a little effect on your stress and therefore on your blood pressure, very little. Then there is something called as Bhuyama ka Laki. I don't know if that's the correct pronunciation or not. Now in other words, it is also called as Phalanthus niruri. It is also a tropical plant found in coastal region. It's also called stonebreaker or seed under leaf, and this also has a lot of medical usage, but the only thing which has been proven is that it actually inhibits some kidney stone formation. So that's one usefulness, and because kidneys are important integral part of controlling blood pressure, somehow they have been linked with blood pressure, but then there is no proof of that. One thing which has been proven is ashwagandha. Ashwagandha is a plant, so many years it has been used, its roots, its berries to be made as medicines. It has so many uses as anti-inflammatory. It's basically used for so many diseases, from brain to skin to stress to etc. etc. Right? Attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, asthma, skin problems, sleeping problem, balance problem, backache, acne, and bronchitis, Parkinson's, thyroid problems, chronic liver disease, etc. 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 It is basically also used in treating cancer and schizophrenia. It basically reduces the level of fat as well as sugar, because it is an adaptogen. It reduces your daily stress. It's a general tonic. It makes you stronger to fight with the circumstances which you have. So it's a good thing, right? It makes your thinking ability good. It reduces your pain, reduces the swelling. It is an anti-inflammatory thing, as well as it actually prevents a little bit aging also, right? And so ashwagandha is good. You can use it, but remember, many of the promises have not been proven, but it is definitely useful in stress and therefore in blood pressure. Remember, so it has some chemicals which calms down your brain, reduces inflammation, and your immune system is also reduced, because the immune system is the thing which increases your cortisol levels, which therefore causes high sugar, high blood pressure, high heart rate. So reducing cortisol will definitely help. Then there is Jatmasi. Jatmasi is also a plant found in Himalayas, and it has been used again for so many diseases. It has been used as an anti-spasmodic, bitter tonic, stimulant, and treating hysteria, convulsion, epilepsy, and it has been used for increasing blood circulation, mental disorders. So it is hepatotonic, cardiotonic, analgesic, diuretic, etc. etc. It's basically the things which have proven are antioxidant, anti-inflammatory, and lipid-lowering properties. Little bit. Other things are under research right now. Then the last thing is Arjuna terminalia. It's a tree basically, and the bark is used for your medicinal purposes, and Arjuna has been used for so many years in heart heart disease, chest pain, blood pressure patient, heart failure patient, cholesterol, diabetes, etc. But there is no good evidence that actually it is helpful in so many diseases. But yet one thing is sure, it has been seen, initial research has shown that people with chest pain and heart disease do get benefit in their chest pain, in their symptoms when they are taking Arjuna. So it is promising, although research will prove give us proof whether it is effective in all these things or not. But then these are the list of the natural herbs and the natural ingredients present in your house which are active against blood pressure as a whole thing. So what you can do, you can actually use all this information to reduce your blood pressure. And if you want an advice, okay, which products should be used, there are so many products available in the market with the combination of all these things. So what you can do, you can go out and look for that one product. If you want me to advise, one product would be B capsules from Enveda are having a good combination of Sarpgandha, Punarnava, Gokshura, Bhuyama Kalaki and Ashwagandha, Jatmasi and Arjuna. So many of these things are under research, but some of these things are proven to be helpful in blood pressure, and the other things are already present in your kitchen, so you can use them on a daily basis. And the most important thing is your diet, vegetables, fruits and reducing your salts. So all these things together will be definitely helpful in reducing your blood pressure. If you are actually having high blood pressure, most important thing is monitoring your blood pressure. No matter if you're using Ayurvedic or allopathic medicines, if you want to use allopathic, then obviously there are so many doctors, you can go to them and get a prescription. If you want to use Ayurvedic medicine, this is a good option, B capsule. I'll be giving the link in the description below, you can try it and make sure, doesn't matter what treatment you are using for blood pressure, the most important thing here is to monitor your blood pressure, because monitoring will tell us whether the treatment is working or not. Not everybody will get benefit even from any kind of a treatment, right? Some people will get full benefit, some people might get half, some may not get any benefit. So you make sure to monitor your blood pressure, and this product is a good product to consider. Thank you so much for watching the video. Stay connected, stay healthy. We'll be bringing you similar videos on a daily basis, so make sure to like the video so that this video is recommended by YouTube to others and share it. Thank you so much.